Greetings, students. This brief demonstration video will show you how to create a concept map using the Smart Art feature embedded in many Microsoft Office products. As previously discussed, concept mapping helps you to visualize the relationships between topics and subtopics. A concept map can be particularly useful when beginning a writing or research project as a pre-writing technique. It can also be helpful when studying for tests. By the end of the presentation, you will be able to create a basic concept map of your own. We'll begin by opening Microsoft PowerPoint. You'll notice at the top ribbon there is a tab called Smart Art. You will want to go ahead and click on this tab, which will bring you to the options for the feature. For concept maps, it makes sense to use the relationship group since concept maps are all about relationships. Within this tab, there are many options. However, I often use this one for concept mapping because it is effective and efficient. Once you select the Smart Art tool, you will see the default image appear on the screen. Now, you can alter this image by clicking on the Styles option on the tool ribbon bar. To enter your specific text, you will use the small outline tab located on the left-hand side of the box. There, you'll be able to insert your own words or concepts. Let me give you an example. So our main topic would go here, next followed by a subtopic, and then perhaps again by a specific point. To get to each of the boxes, all I have to do is hit the down arrow button and type. So here I'll type subtopic again, and then enter, and I will get a new point. Now to get that to be a subpoint of that last topic, I just hit tab and type in specific point. And now I can hit to enter and create as many subpoints as I need to. I can backspace that out. I can then also bring the text back in and create more subpoints. Now, I will be limited eventually. It will tell me I can't add anything else. So some of these points might have to become subpoints. This is a good time in the video to pause it and try out some of the steps I've outlined thus far. Okay, once you've completed the steps, you'll be able to see how the concept map is starting to build and develop. But I wanted to give you a quick look at a developed map. Here's one. Now, if this particular approach is not working for you, it's important to know that there are other ways of creating concept maps. There are several apps that you can use for free or for purchase. I've used MindMap and Mindly. You can also conduct a quick search to find a template, or of course, you can create your own template. What's most important here is that you're able to create a concept map that visualizes your thoughts on the materials and helps you to synthesize the information. Now, for more resources on concept mapping, building, and using the Smart Art feature in Microsoft products, go to our course website and click on Course Resources. Happy conceptualizing, everybody!